Welcome. Welcome. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. Immediately we are starting with today's topic. Okay, fine. I hope that my camera is well adjusted. Okay. So, how are you? Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Raghuveer Deshpande. I am presenting in front of you. Today's topic is Pitta Dosha. Kindly note the topic, Pitta Dosha. It's very important topic in the concept of Ayurveda. This is useful for the UG and PG students of Ayurveda because it is a topic from Sharirak Kriya paper 1, part A. Remember, part A is always Ayurvedic and part B is of modern physiology. This is presented by myself, that is Dr. R.R. Deshpande. I am the professor and head of the department in College of Ayurveda and Research Center, Akurdi, Pune, in the Maharashtra state. I am from the Pune, Maharashtra state. This is one of the important books that I will recommend to you, Clinical Examination. This is Narendra Prakashan is a publisher and written by myself and my teacher, Dr. Subhash Anade. It includes all the systems, digestive, respiratory, nervous system, how to examine these systems. Also, this book includes the Srotasa Parikshan. In Ayurveda, Srotasa is a very important concept. Micro and macro channels. How to examine Pranava Srotas, Udakava Srotas, Annava Srotas, Raktava Srotas. Everything is explained in this book. So those who are interested, that they can definitely buy this book. So this is details of myself. I have the post-graduation in two subjects of Ayurveda. Ayurvedic physiology and Ayurvedic medicine. So I do the Ayurvedic consultations. Then this is my personal website, ayurvedicfriend.com. This is my WhatsApp number. Everybody of you are always welcome to WhatsApp me and mail me regarding many things. Okay. So this is my mail ID. I request all of you to mail me because I can do the online consultations for your health problems. I can do your Ayurvedic Prakriti Parikshan and lifestyle advice. Also, I do the palmistry or Hasta Samudrika. Then I take the online classes of the Ayurvedic students for different topics. These are not regular classes. This is franchise, that means freelance. I work as a freelance. So anybody, single student, 5 students, 10 students, they can make a group. Single student can approach me and one-to-one way we can conduct the classes or Zoom lectures. I take always the Zoom lectures, okay? From 1 hour to 2 hours to 3 hours, whatever you want. So these are some of the important books that I will recommend to the BMS students and MD doing the Sharira Kriya. This is written by myself. Kriya Sharira paper 1, part A and B together. It is in Marathi and English language together. Ayurvedic Marathi language, modern part English language. This is for paper 2, Kriya Sharira paper 2. Every Ayurvedic students must buy these books. This is my personal suggestion. This is for rapid revision. This book may be out of print. So you can write me by the mail if you want. I can send you the PDF with charges. Remember, this will be the with charges. This is practical book available in the market. Kriya Sharira practical, Pratyakshika is a practical. So it includes every topic from the CCIM. Okay. This is again the repetition. English books are also available. My Sharira Kriya textbooks are available in full English. Ayurvedic part in English, modern part in English. And if you go to the Amazon or Flipkart, and if you search this particular book written by Professor Dr. Subhash Ranade, Dr. R.R. Deshpande, that is myself, and my colleague Dr. Swati Chodhe Madam. So this book is available on Amazon or Flipkart. Physiology, Ayurvedic physiology book. Very interesting book at a national and international level. You can buy it by Amazon because Saukhumbha is a publication. So these are some of the important, my popular links. I will go to that afterwards. But today's topic is Pitta Dosha. Vyutpatti, Nirukti of the term. How that particular Pitta word has been derived? General location, general properties, general functions of Pitta. That we will try step by step. Maybe today's topic will be Pitta Dosha part 1. Tomorrow maybe Pitta Dosha part 2. So slow and steady. We will try to understand the concept very clearly, but in a very simple, lucid language. Simple language, but easy to make remember, because I am making understanding integration. How that concept can be digested by the 12th standard past students who have completed with physics, chemistry, and biology. We should try to correlate some of the concepts with this physics, chemistry, and biology. This is my own concept. Then five types of pitta already. Maharashtra University of Health Science, Nashik. University has taken, arranged my lectures on pitta dosha type. This is available on the internet on my YouTube channel. So that, then last is the similarities and difference between Agni and Pitta that may we discuss after some time. This is Pitta Dosha. Although the script is in Marathi, my dear students, I am going to explain you in English, sometimes a little bit Hindi also. So don't get afraid. Okay. Sushruta has mentioned Tapa Santape. In this Pitta word, what is the original Sanskrit word? That is Tapa. And what is the meaning of Tapa? Santap. But this Santap indicating heat. So Pitta Dosha is a heat principle related with heating process in the body. Fiery element is that. It is related with the metabolic processes. So Santap is not only anger. Santap is heat principle. Try to understand. We have the Vata, Pitta and Kapha Dosha in our body. That's why human body is called as Dosha Dhatu Mala Moolam Hi Shariram. Please write it down, all these important sentences. This is important Siddhanta or basic principle of Ayurveda. What is the basic principle? Dosha Dhatu Mala Moolam Hi Shariram. Dosha, Dhatu and Mala are like the roots of the trees. Like the roots of the trees. Why they are compared with the roots? Because these Dosha, Dhatu and Mala are responsible for three events in our life. Important three events. Utpatti, Sthiti and Laya. Dosha, Dhatu, Mala, these basic elements of the human body are responsible for creation of the body, maintenance of the human life, and at the last, the end, death, degeneration, destruction is also depend on Dosha, Dhatu, Mala. So they are compared with the roots of the tree. Sharira Kriya subject, Ayurvedic physiology, has another name. What is that? Please write it down. Dosha Dhatu Malavignana. Dosha Dhatu Malavignana means Ayurvedic physiology. As modern physiological terms are like cell, tissue, organ, system, and human body. Cell, tissue, organ, human body. That is their explanation. Modern physiology. They talk in terms of proteins, carbohydrate, fats. So this particular language is of modern physiology. Dosha, Dhatu, Mala is, these are the Ayurvedic terminologies. And they should be understood or they should be mentioned as it is. But for understanding purpose, please write down, Vata Dosha, I personally feel, can be compared with kinetic energy of the human body. Bioenergy. I personally feel doshas are can be compared like bioenergies. Energies existing in the human body. Bioenergy. Three energies, kinetic energy, Vata Dosha, thermal energy, Pitta Dosha, mechanical energy, support, Kapha Dosha, kinetic energy, Vata Dosha, then thermal energy pitta dosh and mechanical energy kapha dosh. Vata dosh, principle of movement. Pitta dosh, principle of heat. And kapha dosh, principle of stability and growth and nutrition. Growth, stability, nutrition, kapha dosh. This is nirukti. Actually, the whole dosha, if you consider the dosha word, only this word, only this one. What is the nirukti of dosha here? Dushayanti iti doshaha, which destroy, which disrupt, which make the imbalance in the other elements of the body, they are called as the dosha. Dushayanti, which damage. Doshas can damage to the dhatu and mala. Dhatu, body tissues. Mala, waste products. So just to emphasize in the mind of people that take care of dosha, otherwise they can harm you. Take care, maintain the physiology of dosha. Otherwise, in the pathological conditions, dosha are like demons. In the physiological states, doshas are like God. Doshas are like God. G-O-D, God. But when they are disturbed, doshas, they are like demons. So on one side, doshas, physiology, like God, physiological action. And in pathological, destruction, like demons. I hope those both the concepts. What is the definition of dosha? Definition. Nirukti is different. Definition of this word, dosha. Cursor, cursor, dosha. Prakrutya arambhakatve sati. Prakruti arambhakatve sati. Dushtikartutvam doshatvam. Prakruti arambhakatva saha iti dushtikartutvam. Prakruti arambhakatva, maintaining your body formation, genesis, prakruti nirman, biotype, constitution, physiology. So they are responsible for prakruti. But dushti kartutva, if they are disturbed because of your faulty lifestyle, wrong food habits, doshas become angry and then they damage to the dhatu and mal. So prakruti arambhakatve sati dushti kartutva. My dear students, I am making the subject vast, vast understanding, holistic understanding. So prakruti nirmanakara means not only your genetic biotype or constitution. Prakruti means every physiology. Doshas are responsible for every physiological aspect from birth to death. But still at the same time, dushtikartutva. But when they damage, not in the normal condition. They damage when they themselves get irritated. And why the doshas become, bioenergies are become disturbed? Because of you and me. We human being is making the mischiefs in our lifestyle, in our food habits. And then doshas are very angry. Another formula in Ayurveda. Vikruta, avikruta. Vikruta, vikruta, deham gnanti. This is the description of dosh dhatumala. Vikruta, avikruta. Vikrita, pathology. Avikrita, physiology. Gnanti, damage. When they are vikruta, they gnanti. Damage the human body, cells, tissues, organs, systems. They are damaged by the doshas. Vikruta. And avikruta, avikruta, physiologically. Vartayanti cha. Maintain your body functions. We are talking general word about dosha. Still we are not concentrating on pitta. Try to understand. This is the background music or background introduction. What is the importance of dosha in our life? For the healthy person. For the healthy person. Write down. Who is healthy in Ayurveda? Who is healthy? Samadoshaha. समाग्निश्च समधातु मलक्रियः प्रसन्न आत्मा इंद्रिय मनः स्वस्थ इति अभिधीयते। सो समदोष समधातु समाग्नि सम समवर्ड, व्हाट इज सम? सम इज अ बैलेंस, सम इज अ इक्विलिब्रियम, सम इज अ होमियोस्टेसिस। सो एवरीथिंग व्हेन इट इज बैलेंस्ड होमियोस्टेसिस देन यू आर हेल्दी। व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दोष इन द कंडीशन ऑफ डिसीज्ड इलनेस? How the disease is formed? What Ayurveda's principle? Dosha Dushya Sammurchana. Dosha Dushya Sammurchana Janito Vyadihi. Prakupita Dosha and weak dhatu tissues. When there is amalgamation, interaction in between vitiated doshas and weak tissues, Dosha Dushya Sammurchana. Samurchana is not normal meeting with each other. It's like a pathological meeting. Physiological meeting, oh namaste, how are you? And pathological, damage. Okay, do you understand? So this is dosha condition in the dosha of in the pathological condition. Let us move further. Swarupa pittam agneyam. Each and every element on this earth is made up of five basic elements. Prithvi, Jal, Tej, Vayu and Akash. Five elements. Prithvi, earth element. Jal, water element. Tej, fire element. Vayu, air element. And Akash, space, this element. So amongst, although Pitta Dosha is also made up of Panchabhautik, Panchamahabhuta, but what is the predominance? Comparatively more, which element is more? Fire element is more. So Pittam Agneyam by Sushrut Sutrasthan. So synonyms, Pariyayinav. Pitta is always having the different names of fire. For example, Vaishwanara. Vanni, Pavak, and Anal. My dear students, you must be very careful about this word. Follow the cursor. Anal. Anal is Agni. Anal is a Pitta. But Anil is a Vata. Here, again, I will make the cursor. Here, can you see? Anal is a Pitta or Agni and Anil is a Vayu. What are the properties of Pitta? Pittam, Sasneha, Tikshna, Ushna, Laghu, Visra, Sara and Drava. This is from Ashtanga Rudaya. Vagbhat is the author, name of the author. And what is the book? He has written Ashtanga Rudaya Sutrasthana. Okay? So he has mentioned these important properties. What is the importance of properties? I think very clear. Any substance has specific properties and accordingly it acts. Action is depend on properties and properties are depend on the dravya. So what is the principle? Siddhanta of Ayurveda. What is the principle? Dravya. Guna, Karma, Siddhanta. Dravya, Guna, Karma, Siddhanta. Ayurveda says, we must understand the substance with its properties and functions. And functions are always depend on the properties. For example, what are the properties of Professor Dr. Deshpande? Just for a casual joke purpose, Dr. Deshpande is quite average intelligent person, experienced person, these are my properties. I am a hardworking person, having the passionate of teaching and learning. And that's why, what is happening? What is the functions? That's why Professor Deshpande has written so many books. Professor Deshpande has uploaded many of his experiences and knowledge to the internet. Professor Deshpande teaching well, teaching nicely. There is a lot of good feedback. Why these functions are happening? Because of some properties that Dr. Deshpande possesses. Now let us talk about Pitta. Pitta has a sasneha, unctuousness, snigdhata, like oil and ghee. Little bit snigdhata is there in Pitta, but is not that much of quality and that much of amount like Kapha. Kapha is a typical snigdha, typical fatty substance. Pitta is not typically fatty substance. He has a tinge of snigdhata, unctuousness, lubrication, fatty and oily. Okay, tikshna, very sharp, like penetrating. Bhedane tikshnaha. I am going to discuss all these things afterwards also. Okay, ushna, which is responsible. Ushna is nothing but hot, hot. Heat principle, hot. What is happening with the heat principle? Because Pitta is representing sun energy. Sun, S-U-N. Pitta is representing sun energy in the body. What is the Siddhanta of Ayurveda? Visarga adana vikshepaihi. Soma surya anilayatha. Dharayanti jagat deham kapha pitta anilastatha. Some viewers may excuse me. Basically this program is for students. So I must say some shlokas, and they are very interesting. Ayurveda says there is a similarity in the human body and the nature. Human body and the nature, there are similarities. So outside there is a sun, inside you have the pitta. Outside there is a moon, Chandra, cooling principle, inside you have the kapha. Outside there is a wind, inside you have the vata dosha. So, ushna is like fire, like sun energy. Lagu, light. Visra, a typical smell is existing in the pitta bioenergy or the element, okay? Sara, little bit fluid in nature, spreading in nature, and drava, typical liquid part is existing in the pitta dosha. Okay, so these all, each and every property is helping to make the good functions of pitta dosha. And what is the main, tell me in one word, what is the function of pitta dosha? The most important function of pitta dosha is a digestion, conversion from inorganic matter to the organic matter. Transformation, changing process. Transformation in the shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, and gandha. Whatever the sound we hear, shabda. Whatever the touch we get, sparsha. Whatever I am seeing, rupa. Whatever I am having the taste, rasa. And whatever I am getting the smell, gandha. All this sensory matter, when we take in the human body, it should be assimilated, it should be converted, which is very proper, which is appropriate for our human body. So sound, touch, taste, vision, and smell, all these sensory objects are getting converted in the human body, which will be suitable, which will be tolerable to the human body. So this conversion, this transformation, this digestion, this metabolic process, anabolism plus catabolism is equal to metabolism. Protein metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism, fat metabolism. All these are under the process of pitta dosha or pitta bioenergy, and all these properties are directly or indirectly, try to understand, directly or indirectly helping the function of conversion, function of transformation, function of primary digestion, function of tissue metabolism. About these properties, one important thing, these properties are not only physical entity, not only physical, they are function oriented properties. Ayurveda has always described these properties not at a only physical level. Try to understand. They have understood these properties, what that property is doing inside the body. So these properties are explained on the basis of their functions. Very important statement. They are not only physical. Of course, there is physical factor, physical matter, physical entity is there, but not only physical. Are you getting my point? Okay, next. Sasneha. Now, how this particular little oil fatty substance will help for the conversion? Just look into your kitchen. Kitchen, mother, father, you are cooking. You are cooking Maggie. So whenever you try to cook the Maggie, whenever you put the rice for cooking, whenever you do the chapati Indian bread, you have to add little bit oil or little bit ghee or little bit water. So it may be water, it may be oil, it may be ghee, which you add while you cook any substance in the kitchen. So cooking is a digestion. Very easy. Cooking is a digestion. So similarly, if you forget to put the water when you put the rice in the vessel of pressure cooker and you have started cooking, after some time there will be small smell. Ah, something is burning. Burnt. What is that? It's a faulty metabolic process. Faulty function of pitta. Karapna, Marathit apan karapla mhanto na, karapla, karapla, dudh karapla, bhat karapla, bhaji karapli. Why this is happening? Because there we forget to put the oil or the ghee or the water. So whether you prepare the curry, whether you prepare the vegetables, every time you must add little bit water, little bit oil and little bit ghee, which is essential for conversion. Because it makes the moistening effect over there. Okay. Next. Tikshna. Of course, this is the most important. Shodhane tikshnaha. Shodhana. To search inside. When we consider a typical mass of particular thing and we want to convert, change into that mass, my heat should reach into each and every molecule of that particular thing. Now I am cooking the rice. So my heat of the fire should reach to the minutest thing. And that's why that fire is having very sharpness. You get a burn, you know, oh my God. A deep wound can happen. Because of the fire burn, deep wound can take place. That is called as a shodhana, penetrating capacity. Try to understand. Okay, so that's why all the molecules are getting processed by the fire. So it is a supplementary to the fire, supplementary to the ushna. So whenever there is ushna guna, there is always a tikshna property. So ushna and tikshna most of the times go parallel together. Ushna and tikshna, ushna and tikshna. Ushna is a fire, tikshna is a penetrating capacity. Fire is always penetrating. Fire. If you have the sadhaka pitta in your brain, sadhaka pitta is one of the type of the pitta existing in the brain level. So if sadhaka pitta is nice, then my each and every word will penetrate into your little molecules of the nerve tissues, nerve cells. They will be acted by the Professor Deshpande's lecture. If Dr. Deshpande is also lecture is having the tikshna property, penetrating capacity, and your own pitta, sadhaka pitta, is having that properly functioning. Okay? But at the same time, this homeostasis is very delicate situation. Try to understand. Physiology and pathology, there is a very small line in between. In between physiology, here on side physiology, on the other side pathology. There is a minor differentiation. A simple line is there. Anytime physiology can be pathological, and after treatment pathology can become physiology. For example, it is useful. But if you eat too much sharp, too much spicy, too much irritating chili substances in your food, hot curry, Kolhapur cha tamda rassa, Maharashtra state, there is a Kolhapur city, and they have very sharp type of the, what you can say, the liquid or the curry, tamda rassa, it is called as a red curry, and it is very, very penetrating. So that person who is eating each and every day very hot, spicy, chili substances, minimum 10 cup of tea or 10 cup of coffee or a lot of alcohol, everything will provoke it. Pitta prakop will take place. And whenever pitta prakop, naturally these properties will increase. And what they will do, here I have written in Marathi, they will cause the ulcers. They will cause the ulcers in the body at different places. Here, aphthous ulcer, APTHOUS, stomatitis, here, tongue ulcer, esophageal varices. You understand? Cracks to the esophagus. In the peptic ulcer, in the stomach mucosa, there will be wounds. Because of this, shodhane tikshnaha. Be careful. These properties are helpful, but at the same time, they can be, if they are getting irritated, your pitta gets irritated because of your faults, your wrong lifestyle, your wrong eating habits, that can damage this pitta. And then, shodhane tikshnaha, that can create ulcers. From mouth to anus. Fissure in ano. What is that? Fissure in ano. Parikartika in Ayurveda. You get the cracks at the anal region. Anal orifice. Bleeding pies. What is that? So we are going to discuss that also. Svedane ushnaha. What is a svedana? Svedan is again the heat principle. Svedan indicates heating process. Whenever you, when you get the sweating, you tell me. When you get the sweating, tumhala gham kadhi hai, to aapko pasina kab aata hai? Whenever there is a heat inside the body, is too much increasing in the summer season, hot sun is there, naturally your body heat is trying to throw out and you get the perspiration. Perspiration is a svedana. So what perspiration indicates? Perspiration indicates there is heat inside. Perspiration indicates heat inside. That is why svedane ushnaha. So this ushna and tikshna properties are directly useful for digestion purpose, for transformation. Transformation of what? Can you read over here? Shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa and gandha parivartana. Transformation. Okay, so this is very helpful as a antiseptic also. Very interesting. Pitta dosha is helping you to protect your body. If your pitta dosha is functioning well, your metabolism is well, your immunity will be best, and you can protect yourself from bacterial, viral and fungal attack. That's why your pitta should be normal. Your pitta should be physiological. Sir, bataye na hame kaise pata chalega ki mera pitta achha hai nahi hai? Two or three simple things. How you can examine yourself whether your pitta is good or bad. Number one, first question. How is your appetite? How is your hunger? Are you getting the hunger at a proper time and a proper way? One part. Second, how is your digestion? Whether you digest your food very easily, normally, within normal period, or you get the bloating, eructations, gas, heaviness, bulging, anah, atop, agnimandya, ajirna, then your pitta is not good. How is your stools? Morning time, when you go to the toilets, how is your stools? Tatti kaisi hoti aapko? Every day morning, fine, fantastic, okay, your pitta can be good. So these are the simple things that you can examine whether your pitta is working well or not. Pitta is a fire. Can you see oxidation process? Oxidation process, pitta dosha. Heat principle, and it's a basic fuel needed for our metabolic process. Langhane laguhu. So, because heat principle is acting on the food stuff. So, whatever you eat, if it is a high calorie food, it will take a longer time for digestion. Because pitta itself is a having laghu, laghu properties needed, light properties needed for easy conversion. If there is a lot of burden on the fire, it cannot be digested. Huh? So, any food stuff, that's why Ayurveda says, what to maintain your pitta, matrashi syat. Eat proper quantity of food. Why that is mentioned? Why that is the advice? Because you have to maintain the lightness. Huh? So, lightness is created whenever there is the ushna and tikshna property. Ushna always makes the substance light. One simple example from our kitchen cooking. If you take the rice, after cooking it, it becomes easy for digestion. Another thing for your practice, diabetic patient, he has a lot of sugar, hyperglycemia, then what you can say, the glycosuria, blood sugar level is high. Many people ask, sir, te ami bhat band karaycha ka, whether we should stop the rice. Personally, we don't advise like that. You can take in a moderate amount, mild amount, but how? What is the principle? It should be easy to digest. Then I advise another thing. First, rice should be fried. Rice should be fried on a frying pan. Rice should be fried on a frying pan, and then it should be put on the fire with pressure cooker for cooking purpose. Every day we don't do like that. We don't take directly rice, put the water and put it on the fire. But for diabetic people, every grains should be first grade, get fried. Because of the heating principle, they become light for conversion and easy for digestion. So this is the thing. Visra. Pitta dosh. Whenever there is a metabolism, some smell is always happening. Sometimes it is a normal in nature, sometimes little bit abnormal in nature, but Vistra suggests, not all the time, although it is in the text, it may be mentioned as a durgandhi, foul smell, but I don't personally feel. I will translate that Vistra word as a typical smell of conversion, typical smell of digestion. Sometimes it is physiological, sometimes it can be pathological. When there is a nice curry is being cooked in going on in the kitchen, when very tasty substances are being cooked in your kitchen, many people sitting in the sitting room, they say, ah, chhan vaas hai to bar ka, aaj kaitari tasty dishta hai. Oh, very nice smell is coming from the kitchen. Maybe nice food is there preparing. So I will having a nice chance to eat very nice tasty food. So tasty conversion gives the good smell. But on the another way, for example, if you have cooked, if you are cooking, for example, there is, forget to put the water in the rice cooking and corrupt, that whole rice has been burnt. Immediately द पर्सन सिटिंग आउटसाइड दे से अते जरा बघा आत मध्ये काहीतरी जळलंय वास येते वास सो दॅट पर्टिक्युलर स्मेल इज रॉंग और पॅथॉलॉजिकल स्मेल सो बोथ टाइप टिपिकल स्मेल इज अ फीचर ऑफ पित्त दोष देन सरम व्याप्तिशीलम नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी सरम सरम मीन्स स्प्रेडिंग whenever you want to act on the different molecules that heat principle fire is spreading all over so spreading all over it is called as a saraguna okay saram vyaptishilam so that is necessary for getting cooked very nicely drava vilodane dravaha as I have told you whenever you want to cook something it may be rice it may be curry it may be vegetable you have to put little bit ghee little bit oil little bit water and then only proper conversion takes place my dear friends very important point you should know very important point you should note in all these properties some properties are looking like a opposite one way ushna tikshna another is a liquid can this together yes yes they can stay together our five fingers are having the each one has a same length no but still they are there and doing very nice function for our human body they are helping us you know how important are our hands are similarly although there are the different what you can say the substances having the different properties when each property at its own place at its own quantity at its own quality then there is no problem for example when I am talking about pitta dosha ushna tikshna will be 80% dravata will be 10% but if it is opposite in spite of 10% dravata is 90% and ushna tikshna is only 10% then what will happen your metabolic process will hamper consider in your kitchen again pitta is always compared with the kitchen mechanism kitchen is the main thing where we cook everything so what I mean to say if we put a lot of water compared to the rice grains and we keep the fire very low what will happen that will take a 5 hours, 8 hours to get the cooking of that rice So what I mean that whole physiology of cooking will be damaged so ushna tikshna drava sara they have their own quantity they have their own quality that much is so samayoga vahitva ayurvedic word is a coordination samayoga vahitva is always there in the properties now the most important part of our lecture be attentive applied part for our practice ye sab samanya logon ke liye bahut faydemand cheez main bata raha hu applied part of pitta guna pitta when is attacking on the rasa dhatu because rasa dhatu is all over the body nutritious material is spread to the plasma so when pitta ushna tikshna guna will spread all over the body what will happen jwar the person will suffer from fever now whatever I am talking for next 3-4 slides is are very important for your practice if you want to practice ayurveda in a very subtle level sukshma try to understand aunshaunsha kalpana write down the word aunshaunsha kalpana I always ask my students to give me the feedback of my lecture mentioning some keywords what they understood more because these slides are not in my book right now so these are absolutely new for you okay so pitta dosha when with the rasa dhatu it can cause the problems like fever or jwara in ayurveda there is another concept burn out syndrome especially european people they get exhausted with the brain they get fatigued they get tired not by physical activities by mental activities and rasa dhatu you know the two important function tushti and pushti तुष्टि पुष्टि. पुष्टि इज फॉर फिजिकल बॉडी गिविंग द फिजिकल न्यूट्रिशमेंट एंड तुष्टि इज फॉर ब्रेन मेंटल प्रीणन फंक्शन मेंटल एनर्जी मेंटल न्यूट्रिशन मेंटल फ्रेशनेस. मेंटल फ्रेशनेस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द पित्त रसधातु एंड व्हेन पित्त इज अटैकिंग ऑन रसधातु रसधातु विल नॉट गिव द फंक्शन प्रीणन relaxing to the mind, they will burnout syndrome. Then the person may suffer from insomnia. Why this we must remember? So we want to treat pitta gna dravya, which will act with the rasa dhatu. Pitta gna and acting on rasa dhatu. One example, very interesting example. Please write it down. Pravala, 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 koral. Prava Pishtivati, tablet of coral is available in the Indian market. Is anti-pitta, pitta gna. But is it directly on the rasa dhatu? Little bit less. It may work with the mouse dhatu. It may work with the asti dhatu. But when you talk about liquid, then what I will prefer? I will ask the patient to take the manuka jala. Medicated water prepared from black resins at night, one cup. That is pitta and rasa. I am considering pitta and rasa together. Write down. Shadangodaka. 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 Best medicated water for all these complaints. For all these complaints. Burnout syndrome, migraine, jwara, as a preventive. Sometimes as a preventive and can be used during the episode also, during the attack also. Shadangodaka. Please write down the shloka. Dr. Deshpande is saying the contents slowly. Musta, musta, parpata, ushiram, chandana, nagaraihi. Musta, parpata, ushira, chandana, nagaraihi. Shrutam Sheetam Jalam Deyam. Shrutam Sheetam Jalam Deyam. Pipasa Jvarashantaye. Pipasa Jvarashantaye. It will reduce the thirst in any fever, even including corona. My dear friends, I am confidently telling you for each and every corona patient of fever. If each and every patient of corona fever, please give this shadangodaka. Next, pitta and rakta. What will happen? Pitta is a dosh and this is a dushya. Ushna, tikshna are attacking on the blood. So, lot of skin problems will be there. Kushta. Skin problems. It may be eczema. It may be psoriasis. Then you have to select. You have to select. The dravya which is acting on pitta as well as acting on the rakta. Then there will be bleeding problems. Example, ITP, idiopathic, thrombocytopenic, purpura. ITP. My dear patients, my dear friends, you must consult Ayurvedic doctors, family Ayurvedic doctor of your own recognition or knowing, or you can contact Professor Deshpande because Ayurveda has answers for all these patients. Sometimes as a complementary, sometimes as a curative, independent or some complementary with the modern medicine. So this we can treat, especially ITP. Frequent blood transfusions are expected. Platelet count is dropping. Normal count, platelet, 2.5 to 4.5 lakhs per cubic mm, lakhs. This may be 1 lakh. This may be only 50,000. This may be only 30,000. So all these patients of bleeding problem, they must consult Ayurvedic physician to prolong the period of blood transfusion, to prolong or to improve their platelet count step by step. Dr. Deshpande never makes the tall claim. I am not saying I am treating the ITP 100% and permanent cure. No, not at all. But I assure that ITP patients, blood transfusion frequency can be prolonged in spite of every month one, maybe after 3 months. Platelet count will be gradually increased, 20,000, 50,000, 1 lakh, 1.2, etc., etc. Because we consider Pitta and Rakta together. Again, I will give the same example. In spite of Shadangodaka, I click in my mind the plant or herb Sariva. Please write down. It is a Pitta Gna Sariva. Marathi madhe tala upalsari mantat, upalsari. So there are Sariva Ghanavati is available. Okay. So Sariva decoction you can prepare, Sariva powder you can take. But Sariva is the best medicine which is having action on the Rakta, reducing the Ushna Tikshnata from the Rakta. Pitta and Mouse. Mouse, you know, the cramps, muscle twitching, muscle spasm. So when Pitta Ushna Tikshnata is attacking, like you, have you heard about the heat cramp? The word, write down, heat cramp. If there is excessive heat in very hot region, sometimes there will be cramps in your muscles. Calf pain will be there, backache will be there, headache will be there. So these are the muscular cramps because of the pitta, because of the heat. So tension headaches are there. You understand? So myositis, inflammation. All the time, ITIS, please write down. ITIS is an inflammation. Inflammation is equal to paka in Ayurveda. Paka, inflammation. Rubor, calor, dolor, red color, pain, redness, inflammatory signs. That is always with the pitta. Okay? So, tension headache, myositis, inflammation of the muscle, gangrene. Koth in Ayurveda. This can happen when Ushna Tikshnata will enter into the Mouse Dhatu and degenerate, disintegrate the muscular tissues because of the ischemia, less blood supply. Pitta when doing with the Medha is a Dushya. Excessive metabolic, faulty metabolic process in the adipose tissue, then what will happen? Free fatty acids will be moving in the blood and that can cause dyslipidemia. Dyslipidemia, major cause is Pitta and Medha. Metabolic defect is there. Metabolic defect is there. Dyslipidemia. So we have to give some drugs, like for example, Shilajit. Do you understand? So that can stimulate, that can recorrect the metabolic process at the level of fat. Dyslipidemia, we have to do the lipid profile test. So cholesterol normally 200 milligram per cent. It should be below 200, but if it is more, problem. Triglyceride level, 150 milligram per cent. If it is more, that can be the problem. Pitta and Asthi, when Ushnata, Ushna Tikshna property enters into the bones, that can be inflammation again, osteomyelitis. So ITIS is always inflammation with the Pitta. Pitta bioenergy has a different variety in our body. Sometimes Pitta Dosh is working through the enzymes. Different enzymes are Pitta in nature. Different hormones are Pitta in nature. Different neurotransmitters are Pitta in nature. So enzymes, hormones, neurotransmitters are Pitta in nature. Next, Pitta and Shukra is a Dushya, damage element. Reproductive organ, reproductive tissue. What will happen? Orchiitis, epididymorchiitis, sulfingitis in the females, inflammation of fallopian tubes, oophoritis, inflammation of the ovary, damage to the seminiferous tubules, and infertility. There should be well quality and quantity of pitta at the level of spermatogenesis. Excessive ushna tikshnata. When it can happen? When it can happen? When your testis will be in the abdomen. Before birth, testes are always in the abdomen. During the birth, during the delivery, they are coming through the inguinal canal into the scrotum. Why they are taken out by the God? Because God is knowing, nature is knowing that if they are kept inside, if the testes are in my abdomen, your inner core body temperature, CORE, core body temperature is too much, and excessive heat always damages spermatogenesis. Patient will suffer from oligozoospermia or azoospermia. And that's why school checking, when doctors do the school checking for the school children or the college youngsters, they must check the testes whether they are in the scrotum or not. If they are in the abdomen, they are called as, please write down, undescended testes. Undescended testes or cryptorchidism. Cryptorchidism. C-R-Y-P-T-O-C-H-I. Cryptorchidism. That is pathological. Okay. Pitta Ushnagun. So Ushnata, I-T-I-S as a suffix. Prefix and suffix. Suffix at the end. Inflammation of different organs. Gastritis, inflammation of stomach. Pneumonitis, inflammation of lung. Always there will be pitta whenever there is inflammation of any organ. Pitta Tikshnagun. I have already told it's penetrating. So any ulcer in the body has some pitta with the Tikshnaguna. Peptic ulcer is the best example. Esophageal varices, bleeding piles, these are the examples. This also occurs because of the breaking of the capillary wall. Because of the Tikshna Guna of the Pitta, breaking of capillary wall, and so there will be purpura or petechi or ecchymosis. Bleeding under the skin, the dots will be seen, and that is because of the Pitta Dosha. So we have to take the history taking whether there is a Pitta Prakopak Ahara Vihara Aushadi, whether the person is consuming any Pitta disturbing food or the lifestyle or any medicines, that we search when the patient comes to us. Okay. When pitta is with lagu properties in excess, lagu is excess. So metabolic process gives you the excessive weight loss in the body. Lagu is a weight loss that occurs in the hyperthyroidism. Hyperthyroidism. Try to understand. We don't prescribe only tablet neomarcazole. Hyperthyroidism having the vata pitta pathology. Vata pitta pathology. And hypothyroidism, vata kapha pathology. Myxedema, vata kapha pathology. Obstructive pathology. Here, degenerative pathology. So we want to treat lagu, langane, lagu. And guru is opposite. Yasya bruhane karmani shakti sa guru. So I will prescribe some medicine which will increase the body weight. So I will prescribe bala, tablet bala, bala ghanavati for hyperthyroidism. So this is the benefit of understanding each and every property and each and every dhatu. Pitta with the visra guna. Now I have already mentioned visra is a typical smell. Already, although in Ayurvedic text or Ayurvedic teachers believe that it is always fetid, obnoxious odor. I don't believe. It's a typical smell during the transformation. But here, sometimes, I have given the example, there is a putrid smell. Obnoxious. Foul smell. Especially diabetic ketoacidosis. This is a different smell. It's not putrid. It is a fruity. Write down. F-R-U-I-T-Y. Fruity smell. When your blood sugar level is around 900 or 1000 milligram percent. Hyperglycemic coma. Hyperglycemic coma. Blood sugar is too high. Patient is suffering from diabetic ketoacidosis. Can you see here? Ketoacidosis. So this is faulty metabolism. Fat metabolism is faulty. That is indicated by smell. Even sputum, for example, if the sputum is foul smell, you can definitely diagnose that pitta ushna tikshna guna is very sharp, and so it has been damaging or disintegrating your body tissue. That's why you get the fetid sputum. Okay, when dravat properties increased, of Pachaka Pitta, for example. Main Pitta for digestion is a Pachaka Pitta. But what is the Pachaka Pitta? All the digestive juices. It includes the gastric juice, pancreatic juice, intestinal juice, and all enzymes. Pepsin, renin, chymotrypsin, erepsin, all the enzymes, they are of pitta nature. But Ayurveda says, pittam panchatmakam, tatra pakva amashe madhyagam. Pakva amashe madhyagam, in between pakvashe and amashe, there is a grahani. In the grahani, pitta or the digestive juices are there. Tyakta dravatvam pakadikarmana. Kindly note this line. This Pachak Pitta has a less dravata. Tyakta dravatva pakadikarmana. When you want to cook or heat transformation process, the liquid part should be less and hot property should be more. But when it is opposite, patient don't follow the rule of drinking and eating according to Ayurveda. Because the modern doctors say every day drink minimum 2 liters of water. Ayurveda don't accept that. Ayurveda says thirst and hunger are the natural senses. So you must respect according to your prakriti, according to the season, and then eat or drink. So whenever there is excessive water intake, there is indigestion. I'm sorry, there is a printing mistake. Electrolyte and water imbalance takes place when dravata and ghanata. Try to understand. Dravata and ghanata is in imbalance. Solutes and solvent. Water is a solvent. Solutes means the char, minerals. So when there is in proportion, then there is a problem. Pitta with the tikshna guna, it can cause autoimmune diseases. You know what is meant by autoimmune diseases? Our own body prepares antibodies and which are attacking our own cells. So bhedane tikshna, they are attacking antibodies, attacking on our own cells, that is called the autoimmune disease. The tikshnata has been increased. Why tikshnata increased? There is another discussion. So the person can come to me and I will explain how that tikshnata has been increased in his body. Pitta, ushna and tikshna both are increased. The one arthritis type gout, protein metabolism problem. Protein metabolism problem. Excessive uric acid formation is there. Blood uric acid level is high and that you get the gouty arthritis. A typical, your, what you can say, the finger of the toe, thumb, that have the big swelling over here, a red color swelling at one night, immediately on a one, sudden of the one day. So this is a very acute condition. When pitta is with laghu guna and attacking on rakta, so that can happen syncope or the fainting. That indicates there is a laghu excess of pitta or the vata dosha. Okay? Pitta and visra in the rakta. That is a septicemic condition, septicemia. The pus is spread in throughout the body and that can give the visra odor to particular, what you can say, the when you take out the blood sample or examine the urine or examine the sputum, you may get, I am not saying may get, something typical smell. Pitta sarata is increased in the rakta, then dysfunctional uterine bleeding can take place. And we have to give the stambhana chikitsa. Sarata opposite stambhana, okay? Pitta dravata is increased in the rakta dhatu, then that is anemia. Because imbalance in the RBC and the liquid part. So RBCs are less and dravata is more. That is not correct. So balance in between solid and liquid part in the blood, that is disturbed in the anemia. When pitta with the tikshna property attacking on the medha dhatu, then diabetic carbuncle can take place. Diabetic carbuncle, pitta tikshna guna attacking on medha dhatu. Pitta ushna guna attacking on the medha dhatu, another possibility, Hashimoto thyroiditis. Again, autoimmune. Hashimoto's thyroid infection, inflammation. Okay. Pitta laghu guna is attacking on medha dhatu. Weight loss will be there. Medha dhatu is a nourishing dhatu. So weight loss will be taken place. When pitta visra guna is increased in the medha dhatu, Medh Dhatu, you know, sweat is concerned with the Medh. Is a mal of Medh Dhatu. So that sved or sweat glands, they will get infected because of the Pitta Dosh, and there will be typical smell. That is called as a hid adenitis suppurata. Suppuration is a pus formation. Pitta Saragun is increased in the Medh Dhatu. Liquid part is more in some glands. That is sebaceous cyst. Sebaceous cyst. Because Medh and Svet are interlinked. Medh and Svet, Sveda Dhatu, Sveda Mala is interlinked according to Ayurveda. Pitta Dravata is increased in the Medh Dhatu. Then hyperhidrosis. Excessive sweating on the palm. Hyperhidrosis. Okay. Next. When Pitta Ushna Tikshna is attacking on Asti Dhatu, osteomyelitis will take place. This is called as the Aunshaunsha Kalpana, very subtle understanding of the properties of Pitta with concern to the different body tissues. Pitta Vistragun is attacking on the Asti Dhatu, that is bone infections with cavity and foul discharge will be there. Pitta Lagugun is attacking on Majja Dhatu, demyelinating diseases. Myelin sheath is lost, especially two diseases you must remember. These patients come to the Ayurveda, and I always suggest that these patients of, say, for example, multiple sclerosis or motor neuron disease, write down this motor neuron disease, multiple sclerosis, Ayurveda is definitely helpful as a supplement. I am not assuring of any false assurance, no, but I can improve the quality of the patient. Quality of the patient, quality of the life. Quality of the life, I am not saying about quantity, I am saying the quality. For example, Dr. Deshpande, can you give some treatment for cancer? Yes. But for what? I am not claiming that I will cure your cancer. When the modern doctors say, no, there is no cure for your cancer, and you come to Dr. Deshpande, now please do something. No. I will assure you, I will try to improve the quality of life of this patient. He will be happy till the end of his life. So this can happen with Ayurvedic co-management, okay? So multiple sclerosis, Parkinson, Alzheimer's disease. So there is a more laguta of the Pitta Dosha, okay? Pitta Ushna Gun is attacking on Shukra Dhatu, then all the inflammations, orchitis, urethritis, sulfingitis, oophoritis. Pitta Lagu Gun is attacking on the Shukra Dhatu, the count will be less, oligozoospermia. Why I am saying this? You have to choose one medicine. This is homework for everybody. Dr. Deshpande is doing his own homework. But this is homework for the students, for the teachers, for the patients. We have to select something food. We have to select something plant, which is Pittagna. Guru in nature, Palya, and acting on the Shukra Dhatu. Can you get all the 3 points together? So Pitta Gna should be there, Laguta should be destroyed, and Shukra, it should act on the Shukra Dhatu. So there are a lot of medicines which, when the patient will come to me, I will tell you what this particular together can we treat this patient. Pitta Visragun is attacking on Shukra Dhatu, there will be pus cells in the semen. Pus cell will be there, okay? Pitta Saragun is increased in the Shukra Dhatu, then the person may suffer from premature ejaculation. Premature, because Sarata has been increased. So we have to do the Stambhana Chikitsa. Okay? Mentally and physically both. Pitta Dravata has been increased in the Shukra Dhatu. Dravata, so more volume of the semen, but sperm count will be less. I hope. So all these things, because there is a next topic that we are going to see in the Pitta Dosha part 2. But Pitta Dosha part 1, this is the Pitta Dosha part 1, Dr. Deshpande has talked about Vyutpatti of the Pitta Dosha. But before that, he has a lot talk about the Tridosha concept, physiological and pathological. Then Vyutpatti, then we talked about the Nirukti, then we discussed a lot about the Swarup and Sangatana, Pittam Agneyam. And then we talked about the properties of Pitta Dosha, that is Pittam Sasnya Tikshnoshnam Lagu Vistram Saram Dravam. And we in detail studied all these properties. So I wish you all the best. Thank you for your patience hearing. And I request, please subscribe my YouTube channel. give the thumbs up, share these all the videos to the different people. And if anything, anybody wants from me, he can mail me professordeshpande@gmail.com for online consultation, for online classes, for palmistry, for any PDF of books, so they can contact me and I will definitely try to help them. Thank you very much. Now I am closing this particular my video step by step. Okay, so stop sharing. So thank you very much, my dear friends. We will go back and I will say,